to you. Everything I give to you, withholding nothing, withholding nothing.
Praise the Lord, my brothers and sisters of our Most High God. It is a joy, indeed a great blessing, an honor, privilege, and pleasure to meet with you via this mode of technology that we have available to us today. Isn't it wonderful? Thank God. Hallelujah. Thank you for being with us. I pray that God's blessings be upon you and that He will speak to an encouraging word to your heart that would help to calm your fears, if you have any, and relieve all doubts. God is able to do exceeding abundant above all we could ask or even think, according to the power that is now at work in us. There is an old adage that I remember from growing up in rural Alabama that says, if March comes in like a lion, it will go out like a lamb. If it comes in like a lamb, it will go out like a lion. I'm sure that many of you will agree with me that the adage definitely seems to ring true for March 2020. Who would have thunk it? Obviously, at the beginning of March, just a few weeks ago, March 1st, actually, my birthday, none of us could have believed or envisioned that we would be enduring these extreme challenges. Yet, here we are. Our world as we know it has been completely shaken. All of our norms have been interrupted. And this has produced fear and hysteria in spite of our best intentions. Even though our governmental leaders or officials are presenting an image of bravado and confidence, there still is an underlying fear that is evidenced in the populace. This evidence of fear is seen in the selfish act of hoarding and reverting to the survival of the fittest attitude, meaning everyone is looking out for themselves. Humbly, I unapologetically declare that our Father told us in His Word that this would happen. Jesus affirmed His Word by telling us that the world in which we live is not our permanent home. He continued, this world, including its systems, will end and pass away. We can see that seemingly happening before our eyes. Now, all of this can be validated simply by reading God's immutable holy word in the Bible. Now, I'm not saying that this is the end. I am saying that those who have a personal relationship with God through Jesus Christ, as declared in the Bible, need not be anxious or fear. Rather, we are to rejoice because God has spoken and there is a word from the Lord. Listen what the Apostle Paul wrote to the church in ancient Thessalonica. Rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. And in everything, give thanks. For this is the will of God in Jesus for you. That's 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 16 through 18. When I was a youngster growing up in rural Alabama, we would experience sometimes very strong tornado-like winds, threatening lightning and deafening thunder. Now, during those storms, we children were intensely scolded and even accompanied with punitive discipline if we failed not only to sit down, but to be still, because the Lord is at work. Maybe some of you can relate to that experience. I'm thankful for those experiences, because those many experiences were real, and they instilled in me an awesome fear and awesome respect for God. And that fear has served me well. Make no mistake about it, the present crisis is a reality, and it will serve us well if we have an awesome fear, if we have an awesome respect for God and realize that He is at work in this present crisis. Yes, that fear, I dare say, will cause us to recognize and be still and see the salvation of the Lord. Again, in my humble opinion, I'm not saying that this is the end. I believe that what the world is experiencing now is just a prelude to the end. Therefore, I am not, and neither should you be surprised or anxious about our present crisis, because Jesus warned us that there would come a time of great cosmic instability. What was thought to be untouchable is now being touched and impacted. What was considered unshakable is being shaken. Look at our stock markets, our culture, all those things that seemingly was untouchable or unshakable is completely, totally changed in just a few weeks. Now, the exciting thing for me and the wonder of it and awesomeness of it all is that all of this interruption is happening, is taking place without one bomb exploding or one gun being fired. Think of that. Praise the Lord. Not one bomb, not one bullet has caused this great shaking and interruption. But there is a positive, thank God. And that, and I find that in my observation, I see that there is a real and a relief for me, and I suspect for many others, that this crisis has forced the politicians to stop finger pointing and shouting and accusing each other. Thankfully, they are finally being civil and talking, at least talking to each other. They are forced to collaborate with each other, to deal with and try to solve this very real, dangerous, and devastating issue. As for the believers, instead of worry, we praise. Instead of fear, we praise. Instead of looking to the government, we look to God in praise. We say, thanks be to God, because Jesus is the Christ of every crisis, and our Father is sovereign over all. Praise the Lord. Through his servant, the Apostle Paul, our Father has spoken to us his immutable word. He is admonishing us. I say again, he is admonishing us that we are to rejoice always. Rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. And in everything, give thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ for you. Yes, we, his servant children, are to reflect his character and shine. I say again, and shine as lights for a dark world to receive light. We shine and radiate his word through Jesus Christ, who is the light of the world. I tell you, it is now time for the church to shine. I direct this message to you much like the apostles did, because like them, it was impossible to always be physically present. At this time, we find ourselves physically challenged as we are not able to physically gather in our traditional manner. But remember, God is not limited to the physical, neither are we. He seeketh those who will worship him in spirit and in truth, not in this place or that place, not in this way or that way. God is not limited, and neither are we. God is in control. I say again, God is in control. And he has given us his word. I exhort you to remember that he has spoken to us in advance through his theme that he gave us for the year 2020. Remember, your God will come. Isaiah 35, 3 through 4. Therefore, strengthen the weak hands and make firm the feeble knees. Say to those who are fearful hearted, be strong, do not fear. Behold, your God will come with vengeance, with recompense of God. He will come and save you. Praise the Lord. We have his word. He's already promised us. He's given us his word in advance. Your God will come. Finally, dear friends, God is a sovereign, and his will must be done on earth as it is in heaven. Just think of the many times you've heard the Lord's Prayer being prayed by individuals in sacred spaces, by sports teams in sports arenas, by military personnel, by law enforcement, even by politicians. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. That one line of the prayer has been said and rushed through without much thought to get to amen. I humbly submit to you that God has heard and has answered our prayer. Now, I'll be the first to confess that I never thought or envisioned his will being done like this. But nevertheless, his will is being done. I remind you to reflect on the encouraging words from Paul. He reminds us that we are to pray without ceasing. Why, you may ask? Because he says, this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. You are to pray without ceasing because this is God's will for you. Hallelujah. I say hallelujah because most believers live for knowing the will of God for their lives. We want to know God's will for our lives. Can't think of the account of many times that people have said to me, Pastor, I don't know what God's will is for my life. How do I know what God's will is for my life? We seek to know God's will. And at least we know in this one point what God's will is for us. God wants us to shine. God wants us to rejoice. God wants us to rejoice. God wants us to pray without ceasing. I found that knowing God's will helps us to discover our purpose. Knowing God's will helps us in our living, in our purpose. Knowing and living our purpose assures us that we can be completely content in whatever state we find ourselves. When we truly understand God's will, and when we truly understand God's will, especially for our lives, we can understand, receive, appreciate, and embrace what Paul has said to us in his text. His last admonition, he says, rejoice always. Rejoice always. Yes, rejoice. Not just in some things, but in everything we give thanks. In everything we will give thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ for us. Hallelujah. Church of God, now is the time to shine. Now is the time to give thanks. Now is the time to rejoice. Now is the time to shine because a world that is deficient in sight is stumbling in the darkness and that need to see the light. Now is the time to lead and direct them to safety. Now is the time for the church to shine and rejoice. Praise the Lord. Pray with me. Oh God of heaven, we thank you today for your loving kindness and your tender mercies. We thank you for allowing us this opportunity to share your word, perhaps to encourage some heart that is disheartened, that's discouraged. Maybe even to inspire someone who has not realized that you are talking, that you are speaking, that your will is being done, that you are in control, that you are sovereign, that there's nothing that's out of control, that there's no devil in hell can do what is being done without your permission. There is no mere man that can cause the type of devastation that's taking place today. Only you, the God, the sovereign God of heaven. And we want to thank you for being God. We want to thank you because you love us. We want to thank you because you've shown your love in a sovereign way by sending your son Jesus to die on the cross that we may live. Thank you, God. Thank you, oh God, for even remembering me. And God, I think of the words of the song that says, someone sought me when I was wandering. Someone rescued my soul from the grave. Someone folded me so close to his bosom. Oh, it was Jesus, so mighty to save. Thank you for saving me. Thank you for finding me when I was lost. Oh God, I praise you today for each one that's hearing this word, that's seeing this video. Lord God, I pray that your will be done in their lives, individually and collectively in all of our lives, not only locally, but universally. We pray for the world. We pray for all those who are experiencing sadness and sorrow and experiencing pain because of the death and the illness and sickness and disruption in our lives and in their lives. Please, God, we pray for your mercy. God, we confess that we are sinners. We confess that we need you. We confess that we are weak, but you are strong. We confess that we could never, ever figure it out. So we ask that you would help us. Help our government leaders, our government officials. Remember our president. Remember our governor. Remember all the leaders of the world, wherever they are. Remember all those, oh God, who are leading people who have a word to say. God, speak to us as only you can and as only you will. I pray this in Jesus' name for your sake. Amen. God bless you today. Thank you for joining us. Until the next time, amen.